So in previous class, we have discussed about what is scheduling and the different methods in scheduling. So in today's class, we'll be dealing with some problems related to CPM. So let us see. The question given here is, draw the network for a project based on the following data. Find the earliest event time and latest event time. Find the earliest start time, earliest finish time, latest finish time, latest start time. Find the total float, free float, independent float. And finally, draw critical path in network and find the critical duration. So in the previous parts, we have discussed what is the event times, what are activity times, and what is float. And event times can, under event times, we have the earliest event time and latest event time. While in activity time, we have the earliest start time, earliest finish time, and latest start time. Then we have the float. Float is nothing but the flexibility in which we can complete the entire project. The flexibility or flexible time which is provided for us to complete the entire project. Okay. And finally, finding out the critical path. Critical path is the maximum duration which is required to complete a project. Okay. So in the question, you can see there are two columns which are provided to us. First one is activity, another one is duration. In activities, you can see activity 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, and so on. In duration, the corresponding duration for the activity to complete are given. That is 3, 5, 0 corresponding to the activities. Now, what are the things that we have to find out? First, we have to draw a network for this particular activity and duration. So before we move on, before we go on to the problem, let me show you what is an activity and what is an event represented in the network. So you can see the screen. A circle or a knot represents the event. It represents the event in the network. While an arrow in the network represents the activity. Okay. So now I'll be drawing a particular activity. Let me show you, this is an activity. So every activity should have a start event and an end event. That is a starting knot and an ending knot. Okay. And the starting knot, let me take it as I. Generally, we'll take it as I and J as the end knot. And the duration or the time required for that activity to complete is termed as Tij. That is normally written below the arrow. The duration for completing the activity is written normally below the arrow. Now, some rules to draw an activity or network diagram. There are a few rules. One is two or more activities should not have same start knot and same end knot. For example, I'll be showing you. There are two activities. This is the two activities. It should not have the same start and the same end at the same time, simultaneously. So this is a wrong way of drawing. It can either have the same start or it can have the same end, but it can never have same start and same end at the same time. And no two activities should intersect with one another. That is, this is one activity here, and there is another knot here and here. So this activity goes to the another knot. So this type of drawing is wrong. That means there is no two activities should not intersect with one another. And last but not the least, and it's a main and important point, always the activity should flow from left side to the right side. That is the forward flow. Always it is from the left side to the right side. Okay. So these are the few of the things that you must know before drawing the network diagram. So let us continue with the problem. So in the question, we have to draw a network diagram, and following details are given for the network diagram. First one is an activity is coming from 1 to 2. That is from node 1 to node 2. So let us draw a first node is 1, and let us draw another node here somewhere, 2. Activity is going towards from 1 to 2, and the duration is 3 days. That is Tij, where I is 1, J is 2, and Tij is 3 days, and the day is represented below the arrow. Next one, 1 to 3. There is another node coming, 3. And it is taking how many days? 5 days. Okay, 5 days. Next one, 2 to 3. It is taking 0 duration. Now, here we come as duration is coming as 0. So, whenever duration is 0, that means time required to complete that activity is 0, then it is called as a dummy activity that we have discussed in the last class what dummy activity is. It doesn't use any time or resources. It does not require any time or resources. So, the dummy activities are normally represented in dotted arrow form, dotted arrow. So, we have to draw from 2 to 3 in a dotted form. This is a dotted arrow. Dummy activities are always represented in dotted arrows. And the duration should come below the dotted arrow, that is 0. Next one, 2 to 4. There is another activity 4. Sorry, not 4. And the activity is 2 to 4. And the duration is given as 4 days. Next one, 2 to 5. There is another node 5 and activity is going from 2 to 5. It is also taking how many days? 4 days. Next one is 3 to 4. 3 to 4, it is taking 5 days. So, another activity is going from 3 to 4 and it is taking 5 days. Next one, 3 to 5 and it is taking 6 days. 3 to 5. 6 days. And finally, 4 to 5, 0 days. So, 0 is coming again. That means no time required. That's not, the time is not required. That means it's a dummy activity. That is dotted line. From 4 to 5, we have to draw a dotted line. That is 0 days. Okay. So, now we have a network diagram here for a complete project. The network diagram is ready. Now, we'll start with the first question in the first sub question in the main question. That is, find out the earliest event time and latest event time. So, to find out the earliest event time and latest event time, we have to draw two boxes at every node. Okay, we'll start drawing two boxes at every node. Every node, we have to draw two boxes. And the first box will represent the earliest event time and the second box will represent the latest event time. So, the first box is the earliest event time, which we are normally representing as TE. And the second box represents the latest event time, that is TL. Time, that is latest event time. This is the earliest event time. Okay. Now, in first case, we have first one, for first node, always the TE value will be 0. That is, the earliest event time value will be 0 in every first case, first node. Now, for finding out the second node, how we'll find out? The formula is very simple. That is, so TEJ is equal to TEI plus TIJ. That is small TIJ, that is a duration. So, here small tij is the duration, tei is the earliest event time of the previous node. So, for node 2, the previous node is node 1 and the earliest event time of node 1 is 0. So, tei is 0 plus tij, what is the duration? That is, from node 1 to node 2, the activity duration is 3 days. So, 0 plus 3. So, equal to 3 days. So, TEJ, that is for the number 2 node, TEJ, the value is 3. Similarly, for node 3. Now, when we come to node 3, there are two activities which is converging towards the node 3. That is from 2 as well as 1. There are two activities which is coming towards the node 3. That is from 2 to 3. Another one is from 1 to 3. There are two activities. Now, in this case, what we are doing is, we are taking the maximum duration. For example, now what's happening here? It is for T, E, J for node 3. It is equal to T, E, I plus duration, that is small T, I, J. Now, the T, E, I value, either we can take it as 0, that is for the node 1, or else we can take it as 3, that is from the not 2, plus the duration. Duration is 5, or else we can take it as 0. That is, there are two cases. We'll go with the first case first. That is, from not 1, it is equal to 0 plus 5. Right? And for not 2, from not 2, it is 3 plus 0. So, which one is the maximum? 0 plus 5 or 3 plus 0? It is 0 plus 5. So, we are considering 5 as the earliest event time for the not 3. The maximum one we are considering. Now, for not 4, similarly, in case of not 4, also there are two activities converging towards not 4. Right? That is from 2 as well as 3. So, which activity is giving the largest duration? It is either 5 plus 5, that is from not 3 to not 4, that is 5 plus 5, or from not 2 to not 4, that is 3 plus 4. 3 plus 4 is 7, 5 plus 5 is 10. So, 10 is the maximum duration. So, we are considering it as 10. Okay, so not 4 is done. Now, for not 5. For not 5, there are 3 activities. One is coming from 2, one is coming from 4, and another one is coming from 3. So, there are 3 activities coming towards not 5. So, the maximum one we have to select. It can be either 3 plus 4 or 10 plus 0 or 5 plus 6. We are considering 5 plus 6. 5 plus 6 gives 11 days, where 10 plus 0 gives only 10 days or 3 plus 4 gives only 7 days. So, 11 days is the maximum. So, we are considering 11 days. Okay. So, here our earliest start time is finished. So, now we'll move on to the latest event time. That is, now earliest start time is finished. That is forward flow. Now, we'll go to the backward flow for the latest event time. So, to find out the latest event time, the last node, that is node 5, latest event time will always be equal to the latest event time, earliest event time of the last node. That is, this earliest event time of the last node, TE and TL, will be always be equal. That is 11 days. Okay. So, for node 5, the latest event time is 11 days. Now, for the node 4. So, in this case, how many activities are emerging from the node 4 that we have to find out? There are only one activity emerging from node 4, that is towards 5, node 5. So, only one activity. So, there is no much of a problem. We can directly do, that is 11 minus 0. That is, to find out the latest event time, the formula that we use here is T. The formula that we use here is T L I is equal to T L J minus T I J, that is small t I j. So, this is the formula that we use in the case of finding the latest event time. And here, the previous node's duration will always be known. That is, the previous ones we know. That is, last one is 5, not 5. That one's duration we know. That is how much? 11. And the duration taken for going towards node 4 is 0. That is, from 4 to 5, what is the duration? That is 0. So, the new latest event time will be 11. So, in the box, you can write it as 11. Okay. Now, we'll move on to the next node. That is node 3. 5 is done. Node 4 is done. Now, node 3. So, how many activities are going from node 3? There are two activities which is emerging from node 3. That is 3 to 4 and 3 to 5. So, in this case, we have to consider the minimum. Same formula we have to use, that is TLI is equal to TLJ minus small TIJ. Okay. In this case, we have to consider the minimum one. So, the first one is from 3 to 4. In the case of 3 to 4, we have 11 minus 5. 11 minus 5, that is equal to 6. And from in the case of 3 to 5, that is 11 minus 6. 11 minus 6 is equal to 5. In these two, the minimum one we have to consider, that is 5. In previous case, when we did the forward flow, that is the finding out the earliest start time, in that, earliest event time, in that we found out that we took the maximum one. In this case, while going backward flow, finding out the latest event time, we have to take the minimum one. So, 5 is the minimum one. Similarly, in the case of 2, there are three activities. There are three activities which are emerging from not 2. That is 2 to 3, 2 to 4 and 2 to 5. In these three, which is giving the minimum that we have to find out? That is, for 2 to 3, it is 5 minus 0. That is 5 days. From 2 to 4, it is 11 minus 4. That is giving 7 days. And from 2 to 5, it is giving 11 minus 4. That is giving you 7 days. So, we have to consider the minimum one. That is 5 minus 0. That is 2 to 3. So, it will give you 5 days. So, latest event time is 5 days. And finally, for not 1, we have to consider the minimum. That is, there are two activities. That is from 1 to 2 and 1 to 3. And we have to consider the minimum one. So, it can be either be 5 minus 3 or 5 minus 5. 5 minus 3 will give you 2 and 5 minus 5 will give you 0. So, we have to consider the minimum one. It will be 0. So, this is the complete network. And here we have finished the complete network. Now, we have to put down in a table what is the earliest event time and latest event time. So, now we can see the network that we have generated. Right? This is the network diagram that we have generated. And for this network diagram, we have to find out the event times, activity times and float, and also find out the critical path and duration. Okay? So, in this network, what is the things that we know? That is TEI. For the activity 1, from 1 to 2, the TEI value will be, from 1 to 2, the TEI value will be 0. TEJ value, that is for 2, number 2, I and J value we know, I is 1 and J is 2. For 2, it is 3. For activity 2, the TEJ value is 3. Next one. For activity 1 to 3, the TEI will be 1 and 3. That is 0 and 5. 0 and 5. Next one. For activity 2 and 3. For activity 2 and 3, the value is 3 and 5. 3 and 5. Next one, from 2 to 4, from 2 to 4, the value will be 3 and 10, 3 and 10. Next one, for the activity 2 to 5, that is 2 to 5, that is 3 and 11, 3 and 11. Next one, for activity 3 to 4, 3 to 4, it will be 5 and 10, 5 and 10. Next we have 3 to 5. For 3 to 5, we have the value 5 and 11. 5 and 11. And finally, 4 to 5, that is 10 and 11. 10 and 11. So, this is nothing but the earliest event times for I and J. We have written in table. Now, we have to find out the latest event time. Latest event for time for I and J. So, for 1 and 2, for 1 and 2, latest event time is 0 and 5. 0 and 5. Next one, 1 and 3. 1 and 3 it is 0 and 5 again. 0 and 5 again. Next, 2 and 3. 2 and 3 it is 5 and 5. 5 and 5. Next we have 2 and 4. 2 and 4 it is 5 and 11. 5 and 11. Next one is 2 and 5. It is 5 and 11. Again, 5 and 11. Next it is 3 and 4. For 3 and 4, the latest event time is 5 and 11. 5 and 11. Then 3 and 5. It is 5 and 11 again. 5 and 11. 5 and 11. Next one, 4 and 5. It is 11 and 11 again, 11 and 11. So, these are the event times. So, event times we have completed. These are the event times. We have completed the event times. So, the first sub question has been completed. We have found out the latest event time and the earliest event time. So, TEI and TEJ represents the earliest event time. TLI and TLJ represent the latest event time. So event times we have found out for the particular activities and the duration. Now we'll move on to the activity time. Activity time. So the activity times are EST, EFT, LST and LFT. Okay. So to find out EST, EFT, LST and LFT, you have to go with the event times. So for finding out EST, that is the earliest start time, we are considering same earliest event time. What is the earliest event time? Is equal to earliest start time. That is equal to T E I. Earliest start time is nothing but the earliest event time. So whatever the values that we have there, we have to put it down here. That is 0, 0, 3, 3, 3, 5, 5, and 10. It is done. Next one, we have to find out the earliest finish time. Earliest finish time is nothing but earliest start time plus the duration. That is 0 plus 3, that is equal to 3. 0 plus 5, that is equal to 5. 3 plus 0 is equal to 3. 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. 3 plus 4 equal to 7. 5 plus 5 equal to 10. 5 plus 6 equal to 11. And 10 plus 0 equal to 10. So these are the earliest finish time. Now to find out the LST and LFT, that is latest start time and latest finish time. Latest finish here, the latest finish time is equal to the TLJ, that is the latest event time. TLJ. Latest finish time is equal to TLJ. So whatever the values which is provided for TLJ for each activity, same values we have to note down. That is 5. For first one it is 5. Second one it's 5. Then 5. Then 11. 11. 11. 11 and 11. So these are the latest finish time. Now to find out LST, that is the latest start time, is nothing but the latest finish time minus the duration. In previous case it was plus the duration, that is for the earliest start time it was earliest start time plus the duration will give you earliest finish time. For finding out latest start time, it is latest finish time minus the duration. So 5 minus 3, that is 2. 5 minus 5, that is 0. 5 minus 0 is equal to 5. 11 minus 4, that is equal to 7. 11 minus 4 equal to 7. 11 minus 5, that is equal to 6. Then 11 minus 6, that is equal to 5. 11 minus 0 equal to 11. So these are the latest start time. So this finishes our second sub question, that is finding out the activity times, that is earliest start time, earliest finish time, latest start time and latest finish time. Now to find out the floats, there are three floats which we have to find out according to the question. These are the floats, that is the extra time that we can utilize to complete the project without delaying the project, that is known as float. There are three floats: total float, free float and independent float. So for finding out each of these cases, we have three different formulas. For finding out the total float, that is TF, that is total float, is equal to TLJ minus TEI minus duration, that is TIJ, small TIJ. This is the formula for finding out total float. Now to find out free float. Free float, the formula is TEJ minus TEI minus TIJ. That is the earliest start time, earliest event time for second node minus the earliest event time the first node minus the duration. To find out the independent float IF, the formula is TEJ minus TLI minus TIJ. So this is the formula. These are the three formulas that we have to use to find out total float, free float and independent float. So in first case, the total float is equal to TLJ minus TEI minus duration. That is TLJ is 5, minus t, t i 0 and duration is 3. That is 5 minus 0 minus 3. That is equal to 2 days. Right? Free float value will be is equal to we have t e j minus t e I minus duration. That is 3 minus 0 minus 3 is equal to 0. Next one, we have to find out the independent float. So to find out independent float, the formula is t e j minus t l I minus duration. That is 3 minus 0 minus 3. That is equal to 0. Right? Next one. In next case, we have 5, that is TLJ, 5, minus 0, that is TEI is 0, minus duration, that is 5. That is 5 minus 0 minus 5 is equal to 0. Similarly, free float value will be 0 and independent float value will be 0. Okay? This I have calculated, so it comes 0. It's how? Like 5 minus 0 minus 5, 5 minus 0 minus 5. So that's how we get independent float and free float. Next one, for the activity 2 to 3, we have to find out, we have to calculate the total float, that is TLJ 5 minus 3 minus 0 will give you 2 days. Okay. Next, 5 minus 3 minus 0 will give you 2 days. 5 minus 5 minus 0 will give you 0. Okay. Next one, 11 minus 3 minus 4, that is 11 minus 3 minus 4 will give you total of 4 days, that is 4. Next one is 10 minus 3 minus 4 will give you total of 4 days. Okay. Then we have 10 minus 5 minus 4, that is minus 1. So whenever the value comes negative, we are considering it as 0 itself. Whenever the value comes negative, minus 1, in this case we got minus 1, we are considering it as 0 itself. Now, in the next case, we have 11 minus 3 minus 4, that is total of 4 days. Then 11 minus 3 minus 4, that is 4 days again. And then we have 11 minus 5 minus 4, that is coming as, we are getting 11 minus 9, that is almost equal to 2. So, we got these values also. Sorry, the previous one we had made a mistake. Here we have 3. The reason is 10 minus 3 minus 4, that is total of 7. 10 minus 7, that is 3 days. Now, 11 minus 5 minus 5, that is of 1 day. Then we have 10 minus 5 minus 5, that is 0. 10 minus 5 minus 5, that is also 0. Then we have 11 minus 5 minus 6, that will give you 0. Then we have 11 minus 5 minus 6, 0. 11 minus 5 minus 6, that is also equal to 0. And finally, the last one, 11 minus 10 minus 0 is equal to 1. 11 minus 10 minus 0 equal to 1. 11 minus 11 minus, minus 0 is equal to 0. So now in this case, what's happening is we can see what are the floats, that is 2, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 2, 2, 0, and similarly we can find out the float for all other cases. Now we have to find out the critical path. We have found out the float, that is total float, free float and independent float. Now we have to find out the critical path. So how we can come to know the critical path? When all the float values are 0, then it is termed to be critical. Else, it is not a critical path. Here, I have written it as C and NC. C represents critical, NC represents not critical. So, 2, 0, 0. The float values are 2, 0, 0. There is one value showing 2. So, it is non-critical, NC. Three values are 0. Three of the floats are 0. So, it is critical. This is not critical, not critical, not critical. Here also one value is number one, sorry, one duration is there, so not critical. And this one, all float values are zero, so critical. And final one is not critical. Now, which are the critical ones? That is 1 to 3, the activity 1 to 3 is critical. Then the activity 3 to 5 is critical. So in the network diagram, the activity which is showing from 1 to 3 and 3 to 5 should be darkened. The arrow should be made darkened. You should darken the arrow. So this represents the critical path. And in the solution, you can write down the critical path is equal to path is equal to 1 to 3, 3 to 5. And total duration, that is critical path, critical duration is how much? That is 11 days. So maximum 11 days we can take. That is without changing the project duration, maximum 11 days we can take to complete the project. 11 days is the critical duration. Critical duration. So this ends the problems on critical path method. I have solved a single problem on critical path method, and this will give you a complete view on how the network works, what is free float, total float and independent float, what are the activity times and what are the event times. And thank you everyone.